Vicodin's never been my thing, but we're getting there. Hey-o. I feel like I wasted my early 20s on uppers because I always loved the feeling of having homework due. Oh, it's great. And I had a friend that gave me some Vicodin, and it's oh my God, I wasted too much time not being on it. Now every day just feels like you're walking through a warm bath and you're a mummy wrapped in love. I wish I had enough for everyone here. I was leaving on tour, and she gave me what I would just call a comical amount, like a hand. It looked like an Eminem music video. Just like, that's too much drugs, isn't it? And she said, oh, you'll have fun. So I flew to New York the next day, and that night I did a bunch of shows, and afterwards I went back to where I was staying. I had a Viking, and I'm like, I'm going to write. I'm going to go to sleep. And then I got a text from a pretty girl at 1 in the morning, and she said, we're all out at a bar in Williamsburg. So at 1:15, I was out at the same bar in Williamsburg, continuing to drink and forgetting that I'd already ingested weaponized nap time. I walked into the Williamsburg bar, and up on the wall, they had the drink special list. And in pink chalk, about two drinks down, I saw two words, and I became very, very afraid that a gust of wind would blow that chalk away and no one would ever see that those two words had been put together, and I needed someone to tell me that I wasn't insane. So I pointed and said, excuse me, do you serve a drink called the Pussy Safari? And the bartender said, indeed, sir, we do serve a drink called the Pussy Safari. And I said, barkeep, what's in the Pussy Safari? And she said, have you ever asked a question that turns somebody evil? That's what's happening in this drink. That's what's going. And the whole time we're talking about Pussy Safari, this barback kid stood a little behind her, making eye contact with me when no one was looking, and he just did this. No. Don't. No one should go on Pussy Safari. This guy depends on people buying drinks for a living, but he'd seen too many good men lost to Pussy Safari, and he didn't want to see me go down that path. Which is all I needed to hear to know that everyone in the bar needed a Pussy Safari. A round for everyone. Again, me forgetting that I'd already taken weaponized military-grade sleepy time tea. I'd like to apologize to anybody that might have been in that bar that night. I did my research the next day. The Beach Boys never recorded a song called Pussy Safari. So the 30 minutes I spent at the jukebox saying, I'll find it, my God, I'll find it, or we die here tonight, that was unnecessary. That was an unnecessary thing I did. I convinced a group of New Yorkers at 4 a.m. that we could walk to the Statue of Liberty. That's on an island, that's not a local joke. And then I took 33 blurry photographs of an African-American couple. Because they were sitting at the end of the bar playing Magic the Gathering, the most beautiful sight I will ever see. And rather than tell them that, I took 33 blurry photographs of them with the flash on. They knew something was up. That was no. Poured my date into her cab, took my first drunk subway ride home. A pretty girl sat across from me. I didn't know what the social thing to do was, so instead I just made contact with the ad above her, and the ad said, the first sign of autism is that you don't make eye contact. So then I immediately made and kept eye contact for the rest of the subway ride. That proves I don't have autism. Snakes know your name on Tuesday, and clouds are just sin leaving the earth, and if I look at you, nothing is wrong with me. Got back to where I was staying, sent an email to my ex-fiance from 5 years ago saying I'd made peace with the fact she kept the cat. Ate half a pickle. I know that's true because I found the other half the next morning in these very jeans. And then I proceeded to write a 4-page handwritten letter to the girl I was staying with saying I believed in her art. You've not seen my handwriting. You know in a movie when there's a ransom note made up of letters from other places? Yeah, it's hard to pull off in that font a joke like, share your magic with the world or I'll smother you in your sleep, JK. Found that letter the next morning and tore it up so fast so Lydia will never know how much I wanted to threaten her with artistic support. I get how creepy that is. Don't worry, I freaked myself out the worst because in my own notebook, I wrote, I just want to be happy. And under it, in a second handwriting I have never seen before, I wrote, we're sorry. We are sorry. We're sorry. I am legion. I contain multitudes. We're sorry. That's the most frightening thing you cannot remember writing to yourself. Jesus, we're sorry. That's as bad as anything gets.